You guys! Come on. You guys, if we don't start, we'll never get done. Everybody?
Oh my god, seriously? We have 12-year-olds in charge of this jury?
I'm 14.
Oh, you're 14.
Anyone could have been the foreman.
One person.
Ah, thanks, Ms. Politically Correct.
Ms. Politically Correct, and you're welcome.
I'm just saying, anyone could have had their names drawn. There's no reason to be mean to him.
Okay. So, we're supposed to go over the rules for the jury process. You have been chosen to serve on a jury for the school court or honor board. For honor board proceedings, the jury is a group of 8 students or peers.
Oh my god, please. Can we just take a vote? Mr. Taylor read us the rules before we came in here. The first thing we do is take a vote.
Why don't we take a vote to see if everyone agrees that we can skip the reading of the rules?
Fine. Who thinks we have heard the rules like a jillion times and that we can skip reading them?
I think I'm supposed to do the vote taking.
This isn't a vote about our verdict. It's a vote to skip listening to you.
I think this is a process about the code of conduct, so don't you think we should at least
what?
Be... Don't you think we should at least be respectful to each other?
She wasn't being disrespectful. She's just saying that maybe we've heard the rules and move on.
Right. So, all in favor?
Wait, we're voting if he's guilty?
Oh my god, no. We're taking a vote about whether we can skip reading the rules, and then we'll vote guilty or not guilty. All in favor?
Okay. So, I guess we can...
Take a vote. Guilty or not guilty?
Everybody write down on the paper, guilty or not guilty, and then fold them and pass them to this end of the table, please.
Why can't we just raise our hands?
It's supposed to keep it more fair to be anonymous, so that everyone feels comfortable being honest.
If you voted, please pass your paper this way. Vote is 6-2.
Which to which?
What?
Which has 6? Guilty or not guilty?
Oh, yeah, not guilty has 6.
So we should be done because 3 times as many people voted not guilty.
We have 30 minutes, and Mr. Taylor told us to all come to an agreement where all 8 of us agree.
So you think guilty?
I didn't say that.
That's kind of obvious.
She's right. We can't just take one vote and be done unless we all agree. We're supposed to talk about the evidence and why we think Patrick did or didn't break the rules of the code of conduct.
Oh, so you're one of the guilties.
Actually, no, I said not guilty.
Why?
Just didn't think it was clear enough. Maybe for the same reasons it didn't go to criminal court.
Right. Guys are just supposed to be guilty because the girl says they are, but maybe she's lying. We don't know.
Well, I don't know how common that is. I mean, I've heard that girls have a hard time saying stuff that happened to them at all, mostly because they're afraid people won't believe them. We took this class
Dude,
about...
when you're older, you'll learn more about it. Girls make you feel like everything is automatically your fault.
I don't even know what we're talking about anymore.
We're saying there isn't enough proof about whether Patrick gave her a drug or did anything.
But her sister saw her the next morning. She described how out of it she was.
She's her sister. What do you expect her to say?
My sister isn't lying.
No one is saying your sister is lying.
That's not true. Lots of kids are saying she's lying. Those boys are saying she's lying.
Your sister asked that you be added to the witness list because she said that you saw her on the morning of Saturday, March 10th. Is that true?
Yes.
What happened that day?
Anne was supposed to come to my room to get me, and we were going to meet my mom in front.
In front of the school?
Yes.
And what happened?
She didn't come, and my mom called to say that we were late, so I went to her room to get her, but
she... Was she in the room when you got there?
No.
Where was she?
She was in his room, in Patrick's room.
How did you know that?
Because I went to the lounge to ask if anyone had seen her, and this boy said to look in Patrick's room, and then a bunch of the other boys laughed.
So it seemed as though a lot of people had seen her go in there?
I don't know.
So then after he told you where she was, what did you do?
I asked where his room was, and I went and knocked on the door.
And?
And no one answered, so I went in.
The door wasn't locked?
No.
Continue. You went in?
I went in, and she was asleep in his bed.
How did you know which was Patrick's bed?
I didn't. Well, I mean, I didn't know then.
She was sleeping. Did she wake up when you came in?
No, but I shook her, kinda.
And then she woke up?
Yes.
What did she say when she woke up?
Well, she didn't want me to freak out.
That's what she said?
No, she said she overslept.
And what else did she tell you?
Nothing. We had to go back to room to get some clothes.
She didn't have her clothes.
She wanted to change.
Why?
I guess she just didn't want to wear the dress she had, so she said she had to change. And she asked me not to tell my mom where I had been.
Did she look hurt?
Well, she was really tired, and she was kind of, like, falling.
Do you have any bruises or cuts or marks that you could see?
No, but she didn't know where she was.
Did she tell you that then or later? Or did someone else tell you?
I heard it later.
From who?
My mom.
She didn't tell her sister she didn't know where she was, but she didn't think of that lie until later, when she got embarrassed about being such a slut.
I don't think that's a good word to use. But she said she seemed out of it.
How old is she, the sister?
She's in sixth grade, so 11 or 12.
If she was freaked out, she wouldn't want to tell her little sister that.
And the sister said she was falling.
Hello, hangover.
And she didn't go to the police for a few days. If she was drugged or attacked...
I think it was a week. She said it was seven days later.
And why did you wait?
I don't know. I was upset.
She was scared and confused. She didn't know what happened. It just took her time.
She didn't say scared and confused. She said upset. And that could mean anything. It could mean she was upset that he didn't call her.
I don't think that's what she was saying.
I didn't know what had happened and...
What made you decide to go to the police?
I just knew something was wrong. I just felt really weird and I realized he must have given me something to make me so sleepy.
Why did you think that?
Because I felt so sick the next morning, and I couldn't remember anything, and also I heard later he posted a picture of me asleep on Facebook.
But you didn't see it.
No, he had deleted it by the time I heard about it.
You said earlier that you and your roommate were drinking with Patrick and his friends. How many drinks did you have?
Two. One while everyone was there and one just with Patrick.
How often do you drink alcohol?
Not very often. I've had it a few times.
Well, what were you guys drinking?
What?
What were you drinking?
Oh, like a punch. Something they made.
Couldn't it have been the alcohol that made you feel so sick?
Not that sick, no.
Because
it didn't feel the same as drinking.
Have you had alcohol more than 10 times?
Maybe more than 10.
There's a doctor's report in your file, but it said that there was no evidence of drugs in your system at that time because...
I waited too long to go to the doctor. Most of the drugs leave your body within 12 to 72 hours, so it was too late.
And the physical contact?
Yes, there wasn't any evidence of that, but when I woke up, I wasn't wearing clothes, and there was...
What?
I don't want to say it. You can read that in the report.
That just seems kind of convenient. I don't have any proof, but I know it's true because I felt weird.
Yeah. And she washed the other evidence off in the shower.
But that picture he posted, and about what her roommate said.
What?
That she seemed out of it when she left her alone in the room with Patrick.
I thought that was the sister.
Oh my god, did you pay attention to anything?
Excuse me?
Every time you talk, it's to say you didn't understand something.
Why are you getting so mad?
This is so dumb, and it's taking forever.
I don't think we've been in here that long.
What's the point? It's not like what we decide here matters.
Mr. Taylor said the principal wants our recommendation, and that he's going to take it seriously.
He's
going to
do whatever he wants. It's just that if he decides what we decide, he can blame it on us. I heard that girl isn't even going to come back after this year. She transferred in January, and all she can talk about is how much she hates this school.
Are you surprised?
This sucks. It's not like everyone doesn't know who the jury is. Guys, no one will talk to us if we say that Patrick broke the conduct rule.
It is exactly.
My dad said this shouldn't even be up to us. Most of the time, Honor Board is about deciding if someone's locker is too messy or some dumb thing like that.
Did everyone even know we had a student court? I didn't know.
What did you think the elections were for in the fall?
Oh!
Yeah, that's right. I don't really care whether people know what we decide.
Right, well, you're in the drama club.
What does that have to do with anything?
Because our friends don't care about being popular.
Patrick and his friends are jerks.
You can't say someone is guilty just because you think they're a jerk.
No, but you can say you think someone would do something like that. It makes it easier to believe someone who says that he did.
Patrick has always been nice to me.
Didn't you guys go out in middle school?
Guys can be nice to girls they don't want to go out with.
We're supposed to consider the evidence.
And there's plenty of evidence that he could have done it.
Could have and did are two different things.
Yeah, but weren't you surprised when even his friend was a little like maybe he did it?
I don't remember that.
What a surprise.
One of them was definitely more sure than the other.
Did you know that both girls were going to meet you after curfew Friday, March 9th?
Yes.
We knew Megan was coming, and she said she was going to bring her roommate, Anne.
Had you met her before?
No,
yeah,
she was
in my
new
history class.
Megan's at your school, though. What time did they get to the room?
Around 10.
Like 10?
And you guys had some alcohol.
He had some.
I got some when I went home the week before.
Punch from the dining hall.
And what happened when the girls came over?
We hung out?
Not too much. We listened to some music. Whatever.
How long were you all in the room together?
About an
hour.
Not
that long. Keith and I took off after a while.
Why did you leave? You're bored.
Patrick wanted us to take Megan to another room so he could be alone with Anne.
So Patrick asked you to leave?
Yes.
Did Patrick ask you to leave?
I don't remember that.
How many drinks did each girl have?
I don't know.
One or two?
Did Patrick tell you what happened when you left?
He said they just hung out.
No.
Do you know where Patrick spent the night that night?
In our room.
No.
Why did he sleep in your room?
He said she'd passed out in his bed, and he didn't want to get in trouble if they got caught going back to her room.
So as far as you know, Patrick slept in his room?
Yes.
Where did Patrick's roommate sleep?
He was out of town.
He went home for the weekend.
And the Facebook post with the photo that was described earlier that you both were supposedly tagged in, did you see that?
I don't think so.
No.
But you're not sure?
No, I didn't see it.
Doesn't Patrick have a girlfriend?
No, he broke up with Jenna in the fall.
I heard he was going out with Maya.
No, they just hooked up.
Why does it matter if he has a girlfriend?
Well, I just mean, if he has a girlfriend, why would he want to hook up with some random drunk girl?
Are you serious?
I think the most weird thing was the roommate. Which one was the
girl with the brown hair? Megan. She was the second one to speak.
Didn't really sound like she was sure what happened. I mean, if it was my friend and I thought she was telling the truth.
She just answered the questions they asked her. What did you want her to say?
I don't know. It just didn't sound like she had any proof. I don't even get why she was there.
Who invited you to Patrick's room on Friday, March 9th?
Keith.
To do what?
He said he brought something back from his dad's liquor cabinet. We were just gonna hang out.
So you invited Anne to sneak out with you after curfew?
Yes, but I mean, we're friends, so I told her I was going, and she said she'd come too.
Had you guys done that before?
Snuck out?
Yes.
Yes. Well, no, it wasn't really sneaking because we had a note to leave.
But that was the time you got reprimanded after forging a note from your parents.
Yes.
When was that?
Right after she transferred here. January.
Where did you go that time?
My brother picked us up and we went to a party at Bennington.
Was there drinking there?
Yes.
Did you both drink that time?
Yeah.
Did you get drunk?
I got kind of buzzed. Not too bad.
And what about Anne?
I guess.
Didn't you get caught because you and your brother were carrying her into the dorm?
Yes, but we'd been up really late all week studying for finals. It wasn't just because of alcohol. It was really late.
On Friday, March 9th, how many drinks did Anne have?
I don't know. One, I think.
How did she seem when you left?
Do you mean, like, physically?
Yes.
She was tipsier than I thought she would be. She was sort of slurry. I figured Keith made her really strong.
Why did you leave her in Patrick's room?
Keith said he wanted to play me a song in his room.
So you left Anne and went to Keith's room?
Just for a little bit. Then I went back to our room and went to bed.
Why didn't you go back for Anne?
I did, but the door was locked and they didn't answer, and we didn't want to make a bunch of noise. I thought she must have gone back to our room.
But
then she wasn't there when I got there. I figured she'd show up soon,
but then I fell asleep.
When was the next time you saw her?
In the morning. She came in with her sister.
And how did she seem then?
Still kinda out of it, but she said she was tired and that she had to get ready to go downstairs and meet with her mom, so I didn't see her again till Monday after classes.
Did you see her in class?
No, she was sick that day. The RA let me bring her some soup from the dining hall.
Do you believe her? About what she's saying Patrick did? Are we allowed to ask that?
Yes, and if you knew her, you would too. Just because a person does one thing wrong, that we snuck out of our rooms, doesn't mean she's a liar. Why would she make it up?
Why would she make it up? Because everybody knew that she slept there and that she lied, so they wouldn't think she was, you know.
Maybe. What if she was embarrassed? And she told a lie to one person just to make an excuse and then it spread and got out of control.
There isn't any evidence of that.
Seriously, you're all about the evidence, but then this stupid idea comes up that there is no evidence of, and you're all like, yeah, maybe that's it.
I'm just thinking about it. There's nothing wrong with that.
Excuse me, you guys. Were you listening in?
Oh my god, I bet he totally was.
No, I wasn't listening.
What do you need?
Mr. Taylor sent me to get Katrina.
What? Why?
He said you were texting about what everybody's saying is.
I totally wasn't. That's not true.
You just need to see Mr. Taylor.
What does this mean? We won't have 8 jurors.
He said it's fine to just continue with 7.
But the rules say that you need...
I don't know. That's just what Mr. Taylor said.
This is so dumb. He sent like 2 texts saying I was bored.
Oh my god, I'm so jealous right now that you get to leave.
Whatever. Fine.
Sorry, guys.
I can't believe she did that.
I bet she gets in trouble with Mr. Taylor. That dude is strict.
I just realized something.
What?
Why didn't Megan and Anne get in trouble?
What?
What do you mean, what?
They snuck out of their room and they admitted they were drinking. On campus after curfew.
2 boys got it. For drinking my first year here.
Most kids just get suspended for that.
Right, but at the very least, they get in trouble.
They didn't get caught. The only reason they came up was because Anne went to the police.
That isn't a reason to ignore that they broke the rules, is it? All I'm saying is, at the very least, Patrick broke the rules by having the girls in his room after curfew and for drinking. We know he did that. But everybody else broke the rules, too.
So you're saying a girl gets drugged, attacked, physically, and you want her to get in trouble. Are we supposed to decide that? That's not what Mr. Taylor told us to do. Right?
I don't see anything in here about it. If we can decide to rule, the more people broke the code of conduct.
I can't believe this. You want to punish her? What would that say to any other girl that this happened to? Sure, you can report it and risk being expelled.
Or maybe it says don't report something that didn't happen just because you don't like people gossiping about you.
We should take a vote.
Yeah, I guess we're at time.
Maybe we need 2 votes.
What are we deciding?
The first vote would be another vote on whether Patrick is guilty or not guilty of breaking the rules of the code of conduct based on Anne's accusation. The second vote would be to determine if all 5 students are guilty of breaking the rules of the code of conduct for drinking.
I can't believe we're discussing this. I'm not voting.
Good, put it done faster.
Okay, I guess we're gonna take the 2 votes. Everybody pass the votes to me, please.
Oh my god, I think I mixed up my papers.
Isn't that them right there?
Oh. Yeah, whatever.
Both votes are 6-1. 6 votes for not guilty for the first vote, and 6 votes for guilty for the second vote.
I can't believe you guys.
Do you think she was drinking?
Yes.
Did anybody force her to do it?
No.
And Megan, too. No one made her sneak out or drink.
Right, and it's against the rules. So no matter what else happens, they broke the rules.
What if I
agree to that? Can we agree to just recommend that Patrick is more at fault? That he broke the rules by taking advantage of her drinking too much?
I'm not doing it. Every guy at this school would think I was a total dick for saying guilty, for saying he did what she said.
But how can you look at another girl in the school again? How can you, and tell them what he did was okay?
Because we don't know he did it. Why don't you get that? She says he did, he says he didn't. We don't know. If he did, then yeah, it's wrong. But all we know for sure is that some girl broke the rules by sneaking out of her room after bed count, and she woke up in Patrick's bed.
And that they were all drinking.
Right.
I get why you want to believe her, but we're supposed to look at proof.
But do you think he did something wrong? Do you believe he did something wrong? Do you believe him?
No, I don't. But it's just my feeling.
I don't know if I believe him either, but I don't know if that's what matters.
I am not getting stuck with everyone mad at me because I'm not on this jury for the stupid honor board.
Perfect. So since he's so good-looking and so popular.
And probably for the same reason this case didn't go to a criminal court.
I hate this school.
Well, maybe you shouldn't go here either.
I'm not changing either of my votes.
We'll explain to Mr. Taylor that we took the two votes and that both were 6-1.
So, then, we're done?
This is wrong. It's just wrong, you guys.
That's your opinion.
Myself to be myself in everything I do.
I am Julianne. I am beautiful, talented, and I celebrate myself.
I am Julia, and I am clear and brilliant.
I am Frances, and I am brilliant, talented, and
unstoppable.
I'm Hayden, and I'm honest and perfect just as I am.
I'm Elon, and I'm proud to be me.
I'm Emily, and I am beautiful, one of a kind, and I fill my life with joy.
I'm Brady, and I am powerful, brave, and free to be me.
I'm Delaney, and I'm happy and fulfilled.
I am Annabelle, and I'm free to be me, and I'm willing to make mistakes in order to grow.
I'm Max, and I'm carefree, joyful, open, and I let go.
I'm Michaela, and I'm open, beautiful, and strong.
I am Tanner, and I am powerful and grounded, and I face my fears in order to grow.